This is your WBZH Daily News Roundup for the Buzz of the North, 910 AM in Hayward.
Civic Media News. I'm Terry Bell. Here's what Wisconsin needs to know. Wisconsin should be a safer place for judges now that Governor Evers has signed 29 bipartisan crime bills into law, three of them in a response to 143 violent threats against Wisconsin judges in the past year. Retired Judge John Romer was shot and killed in his New Lisbon home 2 years ago by a man he had once sentenced to prison. U.S. House Republicans want to raise the Social Security retirement age. They say it's to account for higher life expectancies, but Nancy Altman of the group Social Security Work says it actually ends up being a benefits cut.
You never catch up. Even if you work till age 70, your benefit's going to be about 7% lower than it is under current law.
Altman says the better way to save Social Security is to raise payroll taxes on the highest earners. March Madness brackets can be fun, but gambling addiction is a real problem. Live sports bets in Wisconsin are limited to tribal casinos, but people can still cross state lines to gamble online. Rose Blazinski heads the Wisconsin Council on Problem Gambling.
We know that more people are going to do it, and we also know that more people are going to become addicted to gambling.
March is Problem Gambling Awareness Month. Today was supposed to be opening day for the Milwaukee Brewers, but bad weather is pushing it back to tomorrow. Other games are being called due to weather out east today. When the season finally gets underway, the Crew will take on the New York Mets at Citi Field in Queens. New manager Pat Murphy replaces longtime former skipper Craig Counsell. Don't cry over spilled milk, but what about bagged milk? Quick Trip convenience stores are closing the lid on bagged milk in May after more than 40 years. Company says people aren't buying as much bagged milk as they used to. Quick Trip says customers who had special promotional coupons for bagged milk are being offered other milk products. I'm Terry Bell, Civic Media News. Now, here's what you need to know closer to home.
For WBZH News, I'm James Kelly. The city of Duluth is hoping to boost its tourism in the area with a new team. Mayor Roger Reinhart announced the new team on Wednesday, which will take a look at hotels, restaurants, local attractions, and more to find ways to increase the number of visitors to the city each year. The city currently has a contract with a Minneapolis-St. Paul-based marketing firm called Belmont Partners, but officials are hoping to transfer those responsibilities over to a Duluth-based company. The group aims to identify areas for improvement. St. Louis County has released some statistics from their response to the snowstorm earlier this week. According to St. Louis County Public Works officials, the county used 105 snowplows and graders simultaneously, over 42,000 gallons of brine, and 541 tons of salt. Between Sunday and Tuesday, Public Works officials plowed and treated nearly 34,000 miles of roads. County officials say crews will continue to keep an eye on the road for snowdrift and ice concerns. A popular Midwest convenience store chain has announced it is discontinuing one of its items. On Wednesday, Quick Trip officials announced they are discontinuing the sale of Nature's Touched bagged milk across all of their stores. The company has sold the bagged milk in its stores for over 40 years, and officials say a combination of declining demand and the cost for replacing the equipment necessary to make it are the reasons for the discontinuation. The organization will continue selling jugged milk in stores. If you live in Minnesota and have a dog that just won't stop digging, they could be the next ambassador for Minnesota Energy Resources. The organization is hosting a contest where residents can submit a photo of their dog digging online, and the winning dog will be the face of the company's National Safe Digging Month campaign. The goal of the campaign is to remind people to call 811 at least 2 days before undertaking a digging project. Photos for the contest must be submitted online by April 8th. City of Duluth officials are warning residents that they will soon be paying more for water. According to a Northern News Now report, the cost of water will rise by just over 9% each year for the next 4 years, resulting in each resident paying an average of nearly $13 per billing period as opposed to $4.50 they pay now. City officials say that price hikes are necessary for infrastructure upkeep, particularly at the Lakewood Water Treatment Plant. Utility officials have a number of projects planned. The University of Minnesota Duluth officially has a new chancellor. According to a Northern News Now report, Dr. Charles Neese has been named the new chancellor and will begin his tenure on July 1st. He is currently serving as the vice chancellor for student affairs at the University of California, Merced, overseeing the development of student life programs on the campus. Dr. Neese will replace interim chancellor David McMillan, who will remain in the role until June. The last chancellor retired in the summer of 2021. Some Amazon drivers are officially employees, not independent contractors, according to the Wisconsin Supreme Court. In a unanimous decision, the court said they should not have reviewed the case in the first place, upholding the ruling that drivers in the Amazon Flex program are part of the state's unemployment insurance system and are entitled to jobless pay if they are laid off. As a result of the upheld ruling, Amazon Logistics will likely have to pay an additional $200,000 or more in taxes. Charges against the former Duluth Edison music teacher accused of sexual assault have been dropped. According to the St. Louis County Attorney's Office, 48-year-old John Horgensheimer was accused of inappropriately touching a student's chest. He was charged earlier this month and resigned after the charges were filed. The St. Louis County Attorney's Office also said the investigation is still open and they could not comment on the reason that the charges were dismissed or if Horgensheimer will be charged again. And that's what you need to know. For WBZH News, I'm James Kelly.
The Bucks lose Pat Beverley. Hi, I'm Mike Clemens with sports. It happened Sunday night. Bucks guard Pat Beverley says his right wrist kept bothering him during warm-ups. He still played in the game against the Thunder, then had x-rays the next day.
Talked to the doctor and informed me that I tore a ligament in my right wrist and gonna need it surgically repaired, which takes 3 to 4 months.
Beverley likely done for the season. The Bucks face the Pelicans tonight in New Orleans. College basketball tonight at the Kohl Center in Madison. The Badgers women's team faces the Illinois State Redbirds in the NIT. NFL, Packers wrapping up owners' meetings in Orlando. Matt LaFleur on why he's really excited. They've added Giants safety Xavier McKinney to the defense.
I love just his ability to make plays on the ball. I think you saw it in particular, two plays that stick out to me were in that Philly game where he makes an unbelievable interception on the sidelines, and then the very next play they try to run a screen and he dissects the screen and jumps in front and picks off the ball, like back-to-back two interceptions.
Jordan Love says he learned hard lessons about protecting the football in college at Utah State.
And that's one thing I did a little bit too much in college, was trying to make those Superman throws and extend every play and throw it in. Nah, these guys are they're fast in the NFL. They're going to recover on that ball and pick it. So just that fine line of understanding when to try and make those heroic plays and put the team on your back and when to throw it away to, you know, live to fight another down, things like that.
Baseball, the Brewers and Mets game canceled due to poor weather in New York. The two teams will try again tomorrow. Bob Uecker says he'll be back in the broadcast booth for opening day next week at American Family Field. Then it's day to day after that. Uecker is 90 years old and has been calling Brewers games since 1971.
Just a bit outside.
With sports, I'm Mike Clemens.
It is going to be a little warmer today and considerably less windy. Partly cloudy, 35 our high. The wind out of the west at 5 to 15 today. Tonight, partly cloudy, 8 above tomorrow. A mix of clouds and sunshine, 45 with some scattered rain and snow showers tomorrow night. I'm meteorologist Sean Cable. Currently, it's 17.
That's your WBZH Daily News Roundup from Civic Media. Subscribe to this podcast on Spotify, Apple, or wherever you find your podcasts. Find more news at buzzofthenorth.com.